ODL material is different than textbooks. ODL material has a typical structure. It is interactive in nature. Lot of systematic instructional design is involved in development of this material. So, after all these efforts, after systematic instructional design, whatever output is achieved is altogether different. Let us understand structure and nature of this open and distance learning material. Let us understand it in three sections: introductory material, teaching and activities, and the third part is closure material. What is there in introductory material? In introductory material, we write introduction of that particular module, we write specific objectives or performance outcomes, we have the entire content list which gives structure of that particular module. It may be numbered, it may have some sub concepts also, sub contents also. We need to define prerequisite knowledge of a learner. We may also plan for a small short test so that learners can assess their own previous knowledge before proceeding with learning. For some units, some equipment may be needed. For example, if that particular learning is happening about drafting, engineering drawing, then they may require some material for practicing. So, list of such equipment which can be kept ready by the learners. The material can even be for tailoring. So, first we need to mention for that particular module what equipments should be kept ready by the learners. There may be some other references also. So, we may mention such reference books, say some other books which need to be kept ready to refer while going through this ODL material. And we may also mention how much time will be required for going through this particular module. All these things appear in introductory part. So, the learner is ready to learn after going through all this material. Now, what is there in the actual teaching material? The learning material is very elaborative. We have seen that the material should have language which is in communication style, which is in dialogue style. The material is written in very elaborative manner. The learner is addressed at every step. References of previous knowledge are given at every stage. The language should be very simple. Small sentences should be formed. Context of other modules should be mentioned. Various examples can be used. Illustrations, examples help in elaboration and understanding of the content. Along with these examples, some graphics can be used. Some illustrations, photographs, diagrams, charts, graphs can be used. In the flow of learning, the learner needs to be very active. For that, various activities and exercises need to be used in between. The learner should feel that he or she is sitting in the class, interacting with the teacher, interacting with other peers. This interactivity can be achieved through such exercises. There can be some boxes in between. Some scenarios can be given. Some typical examples can be written. Some highlights, points to remember can also be written in such boxes. So, you can imagine that the entire module is very colorful with various shapes, boxes, various scenarios, illustrations, diagrams. At the end of this module, a brief summary can be written. So, in the closing material, summary is written, some unit and exercises are given, which exercises will help learners to understand whether they have achieved objectives of that particular module or not. Then there are some references given for additional reading, for additional understanding of the content. If your material is electronic material, then some link to go to the next chunk should be provided. This is how the entire material is structured and planned. What kind of activities and exercises can be included in this ODL material? We have seen that learners can come out with their previous knowledge, their previous experiences. So, we can tell learners to recall their experiences, give illustrations from their own life. We can simply tell them to restate principles, facts whatever are given in the content. But only restating these facts and principles will not help them acquire knowledge. We also need to give them opportunity to apply knowledge. So, some questions which are application based would help in such exercises. So, giving different examples of concepts and principles, differentiating between a few examples related to some concepts and principles would help. Restating rules would help, and application of some rules and deciding what is the correct answer would help. Choosing from the given list of examples, arriving at the correct decision may be one kind of exercise. Instead of giving all characteristics by yourselves, you can give a list of characteristics in which a few characteristics are not applicable and a few are correct characteristics, and learners can be told to choose right answers. You can give some examples and tell the learners to categorize these examples. Some examples will be of one category, that is one concept, and the other examples might be of different category, which is altogether another concept. This will help learners to understand difference between these examples and these examples, and its two sets of examples are actually examples of two different concepts. So, here you are not directly teaching them concept, but making them first understand the concept. Try to come out with such exercises where learners are using their cognitive abilities, their comparison and differentiating abilities, their identification abilities, and this logic would ultimately lead them to understanding of the concept. Tell them to apply principles. Tell them to apply concepts which they have understood in new situations. How are feedback given? What kind of exercises can we give? There can be some question-based exercises. There are direct right or wrong answers to these questions. In electronic material, immediate feedback can be given. But in print material, either you can provide a list of correct answers at the end of the unit or immediately after you ask these questions. Sometimes there may not be one correct answer. If the question is elaborative, if the question requires long answers to be typed or written, then some model answers can be provided because you won't know what exactly will be written by the learner. Sometimes you even cannot give them model answers. For example, whenever you are asking them to provide their own example, how would you evaluate that? You need to provide some hint for the answer. So, by reading that hint, the learner can compare whether his or her own answer is right or wrong. All these have specific questions and answers expected. But apart from these exercises of questions, answers, choosing correct answers, we may give them some activities. We may give them some assignments to do and some projects to undertake. Some activities can be external activities. For example, we can tell them to go to market and find out rates, find out market trends. Remember that experiential learning is very important in open and distance learning experiences. We can tell them to do certain things. They can interview a person. They can watch a program and write reflections about it. They can come out with a model which they themselves have built. They can write a diary also. All these experiences will keep them active, will give them chance to explore more, and will give them chance to apply whatever knowledge they are acquiring. Rowntree has given nice typology of these activities. Let us understand from what Rowntree has given. One type can be report on own observations or experience. So, learners can write from their own observations, their own experiences, such as recall some occasions when you found this. It can be merely recalling what has been taught. So, you may ask them definitions, you can ask them to write meaning in their own words, or what do these initials stand for. They can either give their own examples or they can identify examples from the given list. You may say that which of the following examples is the correct example of concept ABC. You can also ask them to give their own examples. You may explain a concept. You may give several examples in ODL material, but ultimately tell them to write their own examples. For example, if you are giving them examples of teaching strategies, then you may say that if you plan to teach this particular content in the class, what strategy would you use? The other type is application of concepts or rules. You may tell them to apply a particular formula and solve a problem. There can be several types of in-text exercises. You just need to think of an appropriate type. But avoid writing pages and pages without any exercises. You can ask them a very short answer to write or sometimes an extended answer to write. But in between, always use small questions like true or false, matching exercise, sequence in correct order, multiple choice, put in order, complete the graph, complete diagram, or complete the given table, or create diagram, create a model, plot a graph, or maybe writing a report, interviewing a person. So, you have seen typology of exercises. You have seen why exercises are important. What different types of exercises and activities can be given to learners. Our material must be interactive in nature. Systematic material development is needed. Right from writing objectives, analyzing learners, up to planning for evaluation, sound implementation, everything needs to be planned and implemented properly. If we do so, our open and distance learning system will be very effective. Considering features and principles of open and distance learning material, considering characteristics of adult learners, do we think there is any difference between regular textbooks and ODL material? Just think about devices. Are all these devices present in textbooks, say activities, animations? Let's try to differentiate between a regular textbook which is typically used in face-to-face classroom environments and the ODL material which is used for this open and distance learning students who are not coming to the campus, who are sitting in their own houses or at workplaces, or they may be traveling somewhere and accessing this material. How this material should be different than mere textbook? For example, open and distance learning material may have some exercises and assignments involved. There may be some blank spaces given for learners to write something. If we don't make them aware of these exercises, assignments and blank spaces, they will not use it. They will go on reading without doing anything, without solving any exercise and without writing any assignment. Have you seen study tips in any textbook? Textbooks merely present content, but ODL material can give some study tips to learners, some cognitive strategies to understand better, to remember things. Textbooks and ODL material both may have examples, illustrations, images, diagrams, but ODL material has activities to do and also provides feedback for such activities. In print material also, there is some provision to provide feedback on whatever responses learners may give, and electronic material automates all these feedback systems. Textbooks are loosely structured. On the contrary, ODL material has a very tight structure, a typical pattern of modules and units inside. The learner is not addressed as you in textbooks. Textbooks merely present the content. In ODL material, you need to communicate with the learner. You need to address the learner as you and say that you must have understood this, you might have known this, you might have experienced this. Let us now discuss. Let us now understand. So, you have to be very careful while writing open and distance learning material. ODL material has very generous layout. Textbooks may be filled with text, graphics, photographs, diagrams, but we have already spoken about blank spaces for learners where ODL learners can write something. Textbooks are meant for teachers as well as learners. The content is presented for everybody. ODL material is specifically written for learners. Audience is fixed. The learners feel that this material is specially written for them. The textbook writer assumes that these books are to be used in face-to-face environments. Teacher is going to be present for explaining, supporting whatever is written in this textbook. But ODL material writer should assume and understand clearly that there is no such teacher who is going to explain. So, the responsibility of elaborating, explaining, exemplifying everything lies on that ODL material writer.